Well, it's been a rough season for crabbers, and that has a lot of them feeling blue. Maryland and Virginia scientists are reporting a low number of baby blue crabs. 11 News reporter Josh Davidsburg talked to some local experts, and he joins us live in Essex tonight.
Well, scientists say it's not too late to save the blue crab population. They say that everybody needs to work together in order to save the population. He's got the bushels to sell.
And we started out real slow here, but it's picking up.
But Tony Walters says the crabbing on the eastern shore has been terrible.
The old timers say it has happened quite a few times down there, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, the crabs show up.
The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Association just released a report that isn't as optimistic. It says the juvenile and female crab population is dangerously low. Dr. Yonatan Zohar runs a crab restoration project for the University of Maryland Biotechnology Institute.
We are trying to reverse this trend. We are trying to bring back and to increase the number of the spawning females.
Zohar has figured out how to breed crabs. When they're ready, he introduces them back into the bay so they can reproduce.
In about 3 months, to grow from this size to that size.
But this program alone isn't enough. Zohar says the spawning female population has dropped about 85% in the last 15 years.
The mated females, which is the spawning stock, are the ones that are going to generate spawn your next generation, the babies of the next year.
Zohar says everyone needs to work together and protect the spawning females in the wild, so people like Walters will have plenty of bushels to sell in the future. NOAA says if trends continue, we could see an overfishing problem, and that could lead to less crabs sold and also higher prices. Live in Essex, Josh Davidsburg, WBAL-TV 11 News.